Hi folks, G3 here, and welcome to another instalment of My Journey to Go Green. Well folks, thanks for watching this video. If you enjoy it, then please remember to click the like button. And also, if you haven't done so already, subscribe to the channel and click the bell icon so you get notified when I load up a new video. Right, let's get on with the video.
Now, where are we, baby?
We are coming in for our first supercharger use. Here at it's Maidstone Eclipse Park, I believe it's called. So this will be the main supercharger that we will be able to use, because I travel up here quite a bit. It's quite tight. And a stop. Good stuff. So here we are at our first supercharging experience. So I put it into the navigation that we were coming here so that it knew we were coming here and started pre-warming the battery. We haven't travelled very far, it's only been about a 10 minute journey from where we were just picking some wild garlic in Maidstone. So it probably hasn't had a chance to warm up too much, but we'll see. I did see the other day that I'm able to press and do the voice to get it to release the charging flap. So let's do that now. Release charging flap.
It is doing something.
Yeah, I don't think it's done that. I might not have said the right thing, but let's
She's loading.
Yeah, it's loading, but I don't think it's gone and open. So let's have a look. Okay, now my understanding is that there is a button on here that I will be able to use. So we've got either the CCS or the Type 2. So let's go with the Type 2. And I think there's a button here somewhere. There we go, and it's gone and opened it. So now I can just plug this in. It's clicked. Lights are flashing blue here. So it must be doing some communication. There we go, it's gone green. That's very straightforward, isn't it? So I've got them pulled in. I've just taken the connector off of there, pressed the button on top, and the charge flap opened, put it in, it locked. It was flashing blue, and now it's flashed green. It's done the communication, and it started. So that was a very easy experience of getting it to start charging. Just get it to open and let me back in. And let's have a look what's going. Right, so there's a high, it says on screen here, I'm sure if you're going to be able to read that, let's see. A high usage supercharger station, charging limit set to 80%. So because it is high use, it's gone and marked it down on here to 80%, whereas normally I think I generally would have it at 90%. And because of that, it is saying that our time to supercharge remaining is 20 minutes. So we've got 20 minutes to go. I'll be able to keep an eye on that on my app on the phone. It is supposedly still preconditioning the battery for fast charging. At the moment, we're drawing 35 kilowatts, so it's 107 miles per hour. So we've got 20 minutes. There is a penalty fee if you stay in place too long here, because it is a fast one, also a popular one. So we can't sort of stay here too long. Let's see whether it will allow me to adjust that up to the 90%. Okay. Right, brilliant. So it has allowed me to go up to the 90%, which is a half an hour charge, because this is going to be our main charge for now. We've got to get back to Dover, so we need it up to there. So it's a 30 minute charge. And that gives us enough time to go to the shops.
How much is this?
This is very cheap. I think it's 23 pence per kilowatt output in.
Oh, lot cheaper than that one in the service.
Oh, it's a lot cheaper than Ionity. Ionity, they don't want you to use it unless you're one of the
Audi.
One of the big ones. So I think it's Volkswagen, Audi that are in that group. So we're going to go and have a wander to Marks and Spencer's and get a bite to eat because we're a little bit hungry, and we'll leave this charging. So we'll come back in a bit. Well, we've been to Marks and Spencer's and got our lunch. So king prawn, tomato and basil pasta salad. Very nice. Mrs. G3, what are you tucking into? You've got some prawns there. Very nice. And some tuna and sweet corn pasta salad. We've got 15 minutes of charging left. We're 178 miles at the moment. We put on 47 miles while we've been here. And it's cost £3.68 currently. The supercharger is the cheapest of the chargers that I've used so far at 23 pence. That's pretty good. Quite happy with that. So we've got about 15 minutes before we're done. So enough time to eat. One thing that was updated in the one of the last software updates was that you have the number of spare stalls or available stalls at the supercharger station shown on the map. So at the moment it's showing two. But we're all alone here now. We were the sixth one when we arrived, so they were all in use, but they've all finished and moved on now. It's still showing two on the map. Let me see whether it'll be different if we can. No, it's still showing two stalls available. That's strange. So the idling fees here are £1 a minute. So after a certain time, when you finish charging, you will then start being charged £1 per minute if you stay here, to discourage people basically staying too long once they're finished. It has just gone clonk. We heard it go clonk. And now it's showing as 210 miles that it finished supercharging. It was near enough £6, £5.98. So that's great. Let's go and have a look around there. So it went clonk and has released it. Oh, no. What I need to do, I think if I press this, it will release. Will that do it? Nope. Let me go into the app. Charging. Cancel charging. Unlock the charge port. Right, okay, so I've got in my app to do it. There we go, unlock. So hopefully I should be able to take it out now. Was it just... It might just have been that I wasn't doing it hard enough, maybe. It might have been that I just wasn't doing it hard enough. Let's see. Oh, there we go, it came out. I'm not sure what's going on there then. And pop that back in there. It's clipped in place. And shut the flap. Right, that's flat. That's flapped. That's shut. Let's get back in the dry. So that was fairly straightforward. I'm just not sure exactly what I needed to do for releasing that. I need to have a check and see, because that didn't come out quite as smoothly as it should have done. So that was it. And whilst we've been doing it, it's also gone and updated on here to show that there are four stalls available. Although that's not quite true, because you know we're just about to leave. So there we go, folks. That's our first supercharging session at the Maidstone Superchargers. And we've put in approximately 80 miles of range, and it's cost approximately £6. And we've been here for roughly 30 minutes, but we were able to get a bite to eat from nearby M&S, so it's all passed quite quickly. Well, I hope you enjoyed that, folks. If you did, then please click the like button. And if you haven't done so already, then please subscribe to the channel and click the bell icon so you get notified as soon as I load up a new video. Well, until next time, bye.